Hello guys, this is Petros from Full Wheel Drive channel, and today I will explain what a differential is and why cars need it. I'm going to explain this using as few technical terms as possible so that everyone understands. Differential is a car part which consists of gears that give your car the ability to steer. But in order to do so, it must provide the power wheels with the appropriate rotation. Imagine that these two wheels are powered by the engine. This is a distance of 6 meters that the first wheel has to cover, and this is a distance of 4 meters that the second wheel has to cover. Both wheels have the same diameter. If we assume that one rotation covers 1 meter, then wheel number 1 has to rotate 6 times to cover its distance, and wheel number 2 has to rotate 4 times to cover its distance. If it wasn't for the differential to allow each wheel to rotate freely, then both wheels would have to rotate the same. So the first wheel will have to cover its distance normally, but wheel number 2 will have to slip 2 rotations to cover its distance. Let me explain what happens when a car turns so you can understand exactly how the differential works. Let's say this is your car. These are the wheels. Wheel number 1, wheel number 2, 3 and 4. And the car is facing forwards so that the wheels 1 and 2 are the front wheels. If we are steering left, then the car moves from here to here. And as you can see, each wheel travels in different distance. Now, in order to confirm this, I use a radio control car, and by measuring the distance that each of its wheels travel, I found that wheel number 1 traveled a distance of 39 cm, wheel number 2 traveled a distance of 53 cm, wheel number 3 traveled a distance of 31 cm, and wheel number 4 traveled a distance of 39 cm. Be aware that these example measures may vary according to your steering angle. In other words, it depends on how much a car can steer. So if you want your car to steer left or right, each wheel must travel different distances. In order for each wheel to travel different distances, we need to have a differential between the power wheels. This is so that the engine's power is distributed according to the distance a wheel is going to travel. And that is the reason why we don't have any differential for the wheels that are not powered by the engine. If it wasn't for the differential to allow wheels to travel different distances independently, then each wheel would get the same power from the engine. So the wheels would rotate the same, and as a result some wheels would have to slip in order to travel different distances. Now, in a two-wheel drive case, we only have one differential, since only two wheels are powered by the engine. If your car is a front wheel, then the differential is in the front axle. If your car is rear wheel, then the differential will be on the rear axle. If your car is part-time four-wheel drive, then it has two differentials, one on the front wheels and one for the rear wheels. But in this case, a third middle differential should be added in order for these cars to steer. And for this exact reason, the manufacturers advise that when driving on four wheels, you should only steer when driving on ice, mud or snow. This is because it would be easier for the wheels to slip and let the car turn. All-wheel drive cars have three differentials, one on the front axle for distributing the engine's power among the front wheels, one differential on the rear axle for distributing the engine's power on the rear wheels, and one in the middle for distributing the power among the front wheels and the rear wheels. This way each wheel gets the appropriate power in order to cover the required distance when turning the car. To conclude, you should remember that the differentials allowed an outer drive wheel to rotate faster than an inner drive wheel in order for your car to turn. And differential also affects how much torque and top speed your car has. This is because a differential is used as a reduction gear in order to provide the desired ratio. That's it for today guys, please don't forget to like this video and subscribe to 4 Wheel Drive channel. If you have any questions, please comment below.